Hi, welcome dear students to third video of chapter 4. Today I am going to explain about step 2 of 6 and step 3 of 6 of main box. Step 2 of 6, select starting documents. Here you can see the image of step 2. The starting document types depends on the document you are creating. So you can see here the different options available in the right panel. Select a starting document here. Okay, so first one is use the current document. Use the current document. So this is used if you have already created the document and the document is current window on which you are working. So this is the default, can see here the default option of the how do you want to set up your letters. This is the default option, use the current document. Next option is start from a template. Start from template, this is used if you want to use a built-in template. For example, if you want to download a various types of design of the different letter format or bioletter, different types of letter format available. Okay, so you can download as per your requirements. That's true. And it will help you to get a desired format from the samples which is already built in. So you can download download and you will get the sample online. Third one is start from existing document. Third option is start from existing document. So this is used if you have already created the document and the document is saved on the system. So third option is start from existing document. If you have already created this document and the document is a document is saved on the system, so you can use this existing document. And another is you have three types of document option, that is use current document and start from a template and start from the existing document. So use the current document is the default selection options. On the task pane, select the type of document to be used for the mailbox and click on the use the current document button and go to the step 2 of 6. Click on the next selection recipient. You can see here the step 2 of 6. So I hope you understood the step 2. Now third step is step 3 of 6, select recipient. Here you can see on the task pane, select the recipients. Now you need an address list from which Word can automatically place each address into the document. So this list can be an existing file such as Excel workbook, or we can also type a new address list from the within the mail merge wizard. There is also an option where you can enter the title, name, address, or you can create the format also there, your address, phone number as per your requirement. So this list can be an existing file such as Excel workbook, or we can also type a new address list from within the mail merge wizard. So as we are creating the data source for the first time, choose type a new list. Okay, so first when going to create a first time, then choose type a new list. And then click on create. So the new address list dialog box will appear. This dialog box will help to create a data source. Okay, so enter the details of the recipient in the text box. You can see here, once you click on the entry, the details text boxes pop-up window will appear, the new address list, where and enter the new address and press OK. So when we open or create a data source by using the mail merge wizard, we are instructing Word to use a specific set of variables in information for our merge. Yes, true. So this is the third step, and just once you enter the code, click OK, we are done. The save address list box, list dialog box will appear, and enter a name for the data source in the file name textbook, and again the click on the save. That's true. So a list of the recipient details entered appears in the mail merge recipients windows, and select the recipient to the added to the main document by checking the box next to the recipient. By default, tick marks are placed on the checkbox next to the data source field. And I will hope you understood the mail merge recipients window, which I explained, and data source field, we're able to then click on OK button and the close the window. So I hope you understood. Next class we'll discuss from the next topic, that is step 3 and 4. Thanks for watching video.